In the next few minutes, I'm going to break down why you could love consuming personal development and business growth videos, but never actually get around to truly implementing it and what you can do to fix that. Then I'll lay out the steps that I took that turned me from a hardcore consumer to an actual producer and taking action on a consistent basis. The big thing to consider here is that a lot of people, and I've been guilty of it just as myself, just as you have or anyone else has, is we focus on way too many different things when the biggest thing we need to be focusing on is the journey. It's about sitting down and thinking, am I better today than I was yesterday? It's about the progress. It's not necessarily all the times about all the things you're doing or you're learning. You need to just be progressing in the right direction. And you need to just start moving. Think about a car. If you need to be going a totally different direction with the car, you can't start to turn that direction unless you start moving the car forward. So it's extremely important. Just start moving. So I know when I was starting my business and when I was starting my entrepreneurial journey, I did a lot of different things. I did meditation. I bought a ton of coaching programs and mentorships. I read a ton of books. I watched a ton of YouTube videos about personal development and business growth. But although I was doing all these things, I was just consuming. And although it felt that, you know, I was learning a lot and it felt like I was being productive, I was never actually getting anything done, which was really causing my goals and my vision, my really crystal clear vision that I had for where I wanted to be and what I wanted to envision my life to be like. They were all just completely being crushed because I was consuming and I wasn't actually taking action and producing anything. You know, I would consume a lot of information, but I would learn and maybe I would even implement those things and they would actually work for me. And I would actually see a really big result from the things that I was learning and from the things I was implementing. But what would happen is I would learn it, implement it, but then it would just fall off and I'd go right back to my old habits. Or, you know, I would just completely lose track of sight of why I even started learning that in the first place and what my vision was. And it was just an endless cycle like that. I would, you know, I would learn something, I would implement it, and it actually bring me a return. But then I just, once again, revert right back to those bad habits that I shouldn't have been doing. And the biggest thing is that I kept saying, but I wasn't doing anything. I kept saying, I'm gonna learn this. Okay, cool, I'm gonna learn this. I'm learning this. Look at all these things I'm learning. But I never actually did anything with that knowledge. And the big thing as well is that I was extremely misaligned. You know, really simple examples, I'd say to myself, okay, Nick, listen, you're gonna wake up tomorrow at this time, you're gonna do this, this, and this, and I would promise myself in my head, subconsciously, that I'm gonna do these things. But the thing is, I wouldn't wake up at the time that I said I would, and I wouldn't do what I said I was gonna do, and I was just completely cheating myself. I was lying to myself. And this is the basis of why most people are stressed and why most people are worried nowadays. It's not because they're not doing what they want to do, and it's not because they're in a hard spot. You can be in a hard spot, and if you're constantly lying to yourself and saying, okay, I'm going to do these things, I will do this tomorrow, and then you don't do it, you're going to be just as stressed. Even if you're a person that isn't extremely successful, you're telling yourself you're going to do something, and you don't do it. It's the biggest cause of stress is this misalignment in your life. This is the biggest reason that there's friction in your life right now and in my life when I was having these issues. You end up losing trust and respect in yourself, and how can you expect others to trust and respect you if you subconsciously aren't even respecting and trusting yourself? You'll say X and you'll end up doing Y, and it's everything is just mismatched and not aligned in your head. And even though it's something as simple as saying you're going to get up at a certain time and not doing it, or you know, saying you're going to do something and then never delivering fully on it, it's going to stick with you and it's really going to start to hurt where you want to go in your life, and it's going to start to hurt your vision a ton. You know, when I realized these things and I realized, shoot, I told myself I would do these things, but I didn't do it, I would end up hiding. I would just go in game. I'd go on YouTube. I'd just watch Netflix and just push it all aside. And maybe I would even learn some things about business. I'd maybe read a book, or I maybe watch YouTube videos when I started getting back, but I would never truly implement them. And so that's what this video is about. It's about this dopamine detox. We have so many options of what to learn, but we never really actually do anything. And the small little hacks that you learn from, whether it's a guru or from a book, or even that you maybe come up with yourself, these small hacks will only work for a small period of time, but then they'll just kind of fall off and you'll revert right back into that negative downward spiral that you were trying to get out of in the first place. And the first issue that you need to be aware of and that you need to conquer is comparison. all misalignment in life is gonna come, or a big majority of misalignment in life is going to come from comparison. Think about different pricing options for a program, or discounts on popcorn, or whatever it is. The only reason the higher price is so high is because those other options are there. If those other options weren't there and there was only one option, you can't compare it to anything else. Everything is comparative. And you do the same thing when it comes to taking action. And our brain will view everything relative to its surroundings. So with that price example, if there was no lower, higher, and mid-range price, that higher, whatever the price is there, that's the only option there is. And it works the exact same with dopamine, and it's hijacking your potential for your life and your business. For example, if you have a piece of chocolate and a carrot right next to each other, instinctively, your brain is going to want to go for that chocolate because it will release more dopamine. Your brain wants and craves that dopamine. It's an insane, it's a drug, essentially, and your brain will go for anything that releases that dopamine more. And just as the chocolate and the carrot, we will have these same options in life. Something that gives us a ton of dopamine and something that gives us nothing or barely anything at all. And this is where shiny object syndrome comes into play. We compare. And in this case, we're comparing consuming and actually producing something. And your brain is going to go with consuming, or want to go, and it's going to be attracted to the consuming option more times than not. Think about it. It's easy. You just got to sit down. You just gotta learn. You don't actually need to apply yourself or implement and take the actual risks. You're just learning and consuming. It's the easier, risk-free, more survival-based option, which is what your brain's looking for. The choices we have today are massive. If we didn't have the choice of consuming or producing, we would just be producing all the time. If you think about your grandparents, if you see them, they're really never on their phone or on their electronics. They're reading, and they can read for hours and hours on end. And why is that a thing? Because they don't have the choice of hopping on YouTube and watching whoever they want to watch. They don't have that option, so they read. And nowadays, that same comparison with the chocolate and the carrot, that same kind of analogy has been just multiplied billions of times in today's world and society. You know, I have my computer, I have my phone that we have instant gratification with at any time. Just pick it up and get a hit of dopamine as soon as we want. And that's what all these apps and all the things we have on our phones and electronics are optimized towards. Facebook, Instagram, social media. It's all about getting that dopamine hit that your brain really wants. And it's easy, but it's not necessarily beneficial. Like I said, everything is comparative. And with the mass amount of options we have in today's world, you need to learn to limit your options. And this is the first step of the dopamine detox. You need to limit your options and make no options allow that you can compare. You need to try make it your number one priority. Stop comparing yourself to others. Don't make the option even available to you. Your body and your brain craves those options because it's easy stimulation when you can compare and get the cheaper thing, or you can compare and do the easier thing. Your body craves that. You need to remove options. So in your brain, if there's nothing there but the carrot, you need to starve your brain so that carrot is irresistible. If you starve your brain and you limit your brain and you decrease the amount of instant gratification you're doing on a day-to-day basis, you're going to start to have and see the effects of a dopamine detox. And so there's one thing I really want to urge you guys to do, and I'm going to touch on and make another video going a little bit deeper into this, but the first thing that I want you guys to take away from this and actually implement and put into action is work and realize that you have an abundance of options, and realize that instant gratification powers a lot of those options that you have. If you have A and B, if A is going to give you faster gratification, most people will go for A. They'll go for that chocolate bar, but they will never go for that carrot. Not a lot of people will. So just really something simple that anyone can do to really kickstart this dopamine detox and start to gain true discipline so you can reach your goals and your vision and your dreams is start to say no to things, people, and different activities as well sometimes. So, you know, if you feel the urge to pick up your phone, if you feel the urge to click off this video because it's not exciting enough for you, this is the video for you. You need to be listening to this, and you need to be realizing that, hey, I need to have a dopamine detox, and I need to realize that the abundance of choices are not really a benefit. I know for me, the first thing that I did when I started realizing this myself and implementing it is I would just catch myself. Now that you're aware that the first step is always awareness, and now that you're aware of this, whenever you catch yourself wanting to pick up your phone and look at some social media or go on Netflix or game. Just step back, stop yourself. Hey, you know, it's not worth it right now. Just wait 10, 15 minutes. Then try come back to it. Take baby steps. It's not going to work if you just try shove yourself down this hole and you don't even want to do it. So take the time and just step back and delay that gratification. If you can delay gratification for as long as possible, the better it is. Like one final example, getting a flat screen TV or getting the best gaming system, whatever it is, it's going to feel really, really great right when you get it. But when you look on your credit card statement the next day and you see you bought a couple thousand dollar TV, it's not going to feel that good. So same thing. So I hope you guys really got some value out of this video and that you're going to implement it in your life and you're going to be able to use this and see a change in both your day-to-day routine and in your business and into the goals that you want to achieve. So once again, I really hope you guys got some value out of this. I'm going to make a few more parts to this series, this dopamine detox series, because it's something really important that a lot of people kind of miss out on. So hope you guys stay tuned for those next few videos. If you have any questions, drop them down below or reach out to me on Instagram. Glad to talk to you guys. See you soon.